So this video is for all you scientists out there who are considering leaving academia for a career in industry, but you're worried you may get a few years down the road and decide it was the wrong decision and then feel stuck. I've dealt with this question a long time ago in my own career. And while I can't tell you what's best for you, I can certainly tell you my story and why I've never regretted that decision. So if this is what you're thinking, keep watching. Hey everybody, Dave Giltner with Turning Science. Today, I'm in Germany. I'm giving a number of talks here over the next several weeks, and because of the busy travel schedule, I've decided to take my video production on the road. So today, instead of my office, you're seeing a backdrop from the Airbnb I'm staying at here in Berlin. It's about the best I could find. I know it's a little loud, but hopefully it will work. So a common concern that I hear, especially from the scientists that I meet when I travel and speak, as I am this week, is am I going to get a few years into an industry career and wish I hadn't done it, decide that it's actually not for me after all, and wish that I had started in academia but feel stuck. The more time we spend in academia, the more comfortable we get with the environment, even if we decide it's not our best career choice. That's why I think it's worse for PhDs than it is for master's students, and it's even worse for people who've done postdocs. I know this is something I worried about a fair amount. Now, as you may have gathered from watching other videos on this channel, I expected to become a professor for most of my graduate school career. It wasn't until the last year of graduate school, after watching all the other professors in my department for about 6 years, I decided that probably was not the best career path for me, and I decided to pursue a career in industry. And so, although that's what I decided, there was that real concern that would I really enjoy it? Would I get a few years down the road and decide this was just not the right decision for me? So I can't tell you what's the best career path for you to follow, but what I can do is tell you what were some of the major concerns I had when I was considering that path into industry, the specific things I was worried about missing or regretting, and I can also tell you how I look at those things now after more than 20 years in industry and why I have never even once regretted my decision. So what were some of the specific things I was concerned about? Well, first of all, I loved learning new things. I loved learning about some of the new science, the new physics that was being developed during the time I was in school. So I worked in laser spectroscopy, and some of the new branches that were being developed at that time were things like laser cooling of atoms and quantum optics. And it was just really exciting to be able to understand some of this new science that was being developed. It was very intellectually stimulating. Second, I enjoyed the esteem that came from earning a PhD and being a scientist, this sort of ivory tower concept. And I have to admit, that's probably part of why I got a PhD. I like the acknowledgement of having a degree that few people did and doing things that few people did. It was the esteem aspect of it. And unfortunately, I think this is exacerbated by the attitude in a lot of science departments that science is really the best career path, and industry is a second career path. I think that made that concern of mine a lot worse than it needed to be. My third concern was around the loss of job security if I pursued an industry position. Now, I was in the United States, where there's a tenure track model in university. Ultimately, you can get a position you're guaranteed for the rest of your career. And while the early part of your career may be uncertain, because you'd have to do a few postdocs, you'd have to build a research direction and justify tenure. Once you got it at perhaps age 35 or 40, you were set for the rest of your life. Looking at that, who would want to give that up? There's certainly no guarantee like that in industry in the United States. So I was really concerned about not pursuing that path. How would I deal with job security? So what I was worried about is that here were three specific things that I really enjoyed about the concept of an academic career, but that perhaps these would not at all be satisfied with an industry career path. What I found is that they were in fact satisfied by an industry career, just not at all in the ways I had imagined. So first, with respect to learning new things. In graduate school, I had become enamored with learning new science. But what I found in industry is that I got to learn about a lot of new applications of that science. And in fact, there was a lot more variety. In academia, you have to build a single expertise, and you probably want to keep it fairly narrow so that you can become an expert in that field. But in industry, while I continued to work with some of the same technologies, specifically lasers and optical fiber, I got to learn about a lot of different applications. I was always learning something new, and it turns out that stimulated my love of learning just as much as learning about the new science that was coming out when I was a graduate student. So that definitely fulfilled me, that concept of learning for my entire career. Second, While I had come to really enjoy that esteem that's associated with the ivory tower, with creating new knowledge, learning new science, discovering new science, I found that out in the real world, out in the world of industry, there is a lot of recognition and a lot of rewarding work to be done in actually developing applications, or as I like to say, turning science into things people need. That can be very rewarding work. While I was no longer discovering new science, I was actually discovering applications. I was doing things that people needed, and I found that every bit as rewarding as discovering how the universe works. Third, I discovered a new type of job security. The job security I had originally hoped for in a tenure track position where you could get a job and then you would keep that job indefinitely, of course, was not available in industry, at least in the United States. Most employment is called at will, meaning the company can let you go at any time. There are very few contracts, like I know there are in some countries in Europe. They could lay me off at a day's notice, and I can quit the job at a day's notice. What that means is we have to develop a new perspective on what job security is. So I learned that real job security is not about getting that one job that you will never lose, but about developing a set of skills that make you valuable across a broad spectrum of companies or industries, so that if you lose one job, you can move right into another job. That is real job security. But more than that, I learned that that gives you a real flexibility that can be very exciting. I now look at the tenure track position as somewhat boring. I wouldn't want to stay in one job, in one office, in one institution for the rest of my career for 40 years. I've moved around a bit in my industry career, and every time it has been very exciting. So that different perspective, that what originally seemed like a lack of job security in industry, turned out to be a real positive. One, it pushed me to better understand my skills and develop a range of skills and expertise so I knew where I was valuable, but then it also gave me the freedom to move around, try a lot of different things, learn a lot of different things, and really broaden my experience and enjoyment. Now, does that mean you have to work a little harder at your career path and making sure you develop the right skills and a good understanding of where you are valuable? Yeah, sure it does. But if you went into science, you probably were not expecting an easy career path now, were you? So like I said, I can't tell you which career path is best for you without talking to you. I can tell you I've seen a number of scientists go into both academic and industry career paths and really enjoy it. And I can tell you from my own experience, a career in industry for a scientist can be extremely rewarding and extremely challenging. I've never regretted a thing. In fact, in my book, Turning Science into Things People Need, I interview 10 different scientists who have made very effective transitions into industry careers. They all have had excellent careers and are really glad they made the change because they understood how it fit them. So if you were really wondering about this, I suggest you check out my book. I put a link to it in the description notes below, or you can find it on Amazon. Those are my thoughts on why I've never regretted leaving academia for an industry career. I hope you found it helpful, and thank you for watching. If you like this video, please click that like button. It will help me, but more importantly, it will help other people who can benefit from seeing this video, because more likes means YouTube shows it to more people. And if you'd like to get more of these kinds of videos yourself, please click that subscribe button and ring that notification bell. I post about 2 of these a month to help you design the career you really want. Thanks for watching. Now let's get out there and turn science into things people need.